Welcome back to this tutorial series. Navigations play an important role in any mobile application. It allows us to traverse from one component to another seamlessly. We can also pass additional useful information while moving to another component. In this video, we are going to learn about a very important navigator, Stask Navigator. Let's dive in. To achieve navigations, we are going to utilize React Navigation Library. Let's go to Google and search for React Native Navigation. Click on this link. Go to Docs. We first need to install the library by copying this command. Paste it in root directory of our project. Now, we need to install related dependencies. Copy this command. Paste and install. Next, go to main activity file present at this location. Go to VS Code. Open Android. App. SRC. Main. Java. Project name. MainActivity.java. In this file, we need to add on create method. As we already have on create method, we don't need to do anything for this step. These steps are needed if we are trying to add any type of navigator, may it be stack, bottom tabs, or drawer. Now, we need to install dependencies related to Stask Navigator. Let's first copy this command. Paste and run. Next, we need to install gesture handler package. Make sure to specify version as 2.8.0, because latest version won't work with our project setup. We need to add this line in index.js file of our project. This is an optional dependency which will be needed only if we will use UIKit animations for header. Let's install this as well. We'll install pod's dependencies as well. Just hit the command pod install. Before we can run our application, we need to do some additional setup for gesture handler. First, go to Android. Build.gradle file, and add the Kotlin version inside build script. Next, we need to add Kotlin class path inside dependencies. Now we are ready to run the application. Let's run the Android app first. We need to move this whole logic to another component. Let's create a new folder inside SRC. Name it Screens. Create a child folder of Screens. Name it Intro. Create a new file inside Intro. Name it IntroScreen.js. Let's add a functional component in this file. Cut this code and return a simple view here. Paste that code here. Let's cut and paste code related to this component only. Add missing imports. clean imports from this file. Here we need to add navigation container. For navigation, we need unique name for each screen. Let's create index.js file inside screens folder. This will contain all screen name constants. Let's add first screen name, intro. Export screens constant. Create a new folder under src. Name it navigation. Create index.js file. Create and export a function stack navigation. In this function, we will define stack navigator. To do so, let's first import create stack navigator function from its library. Create a const stack from this function. Now, inside the stack navigation, add stack navigator. Now add screen. It accepts property name. This is the screen name. Import it from screens file. Next property is component. Assign it intro screen component. We can also specify initial screen for this navigator. We need to specify the stack navigation inside navigation container. Oops, there is an error. Let's go to index.js file inside screen. Guys, this should be a string. And here we go. There is our first component inside the stack navigator. Let's add another. But before adding another component, let's remove this header from the screen. To do so, we can add another property in stack screen, which is options. Inside that, we need to add header shown as false. That's it. Let's confirm we can run updo this for iOS as well. Great, we do not need any additional changes for iOS. One more thing to notice, our application background color is no longer white, it is changed to gray. We can set this using navigation container's theme property. Let's first define our theme. Let's keep another settings as it is. Just change background color to white. Assign this theme to navigation container. And here we go. Let's now add another component and traverse to it once we click on this skip button. Create a new folder inside screens. Name it auth. Create a new file. Name it loginscreen.js. Add functional component in this file. Let's keep this file as it is. We will customize this file in upcoming videos. Go to index.js file to add screen name. Name it login. Go to index.js file in navigation. add another screen inside Navigator. Aim is login. Component is login screen. Now, add the navigation trigger inside introduction component. We will add navigation action on this button. Now, every component we register with Navigator receives a property navigation. Let's destructure it. This property has a function navigate. It needs the screen name on which we want to navigate to. In our case, it is login. Here we go. If you find this video useful, check out another videos of this series. Make sure to like and share the video, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next video.